Well, good morning, good evening, and good night, guys. This is Todd the Blockbuster Guy coming at you again with another Top 10. I said I was going to do another Top 10 Horror Movies of the Decade, so I'm going to do Top 10 Horror Movies from 2000 to 2010. This one was hard to do, actually. I looked at a list and like, oh, this was very... I liked a lot of movies in that decade, but it was a hard movie to actually rank. Keep on looking at myself and I'm like, I wish I didn't shave my beard off. Keep on saying that. But yeah, I'm gonna go 10 through 1 again, like I've been always doing, even though I've only been doing this for 2 weeks. But yeah, starting at number 10 with Let the Right One In, a vampire movie from Sweden. Pretty good. I enjoyed it quite a bit, actually. Different kind of vampire movie. They remade it, rebooted it like a year, 2 years later. Called Let Me In with Hit Girl, Chloe Grace Moritz. I was like, meh. But I love the Swedish version, but I don't like the American versions of like foreign movies, especially when they come out too early, like too soon. It's like, oh, come on, really? You already gonna make it your own? Try to make it your own? With 9 times out of 10, the foreign movie is way better. Actually, I don't think I've ever seen an American version of a movie that's better than its foreign counterpart. Death at a Funeral, Old Boy, both not even close. Just Let the Right One In, Let Me In, not even close. Yeah, moving on to number 9. This one is Planet Terror, 2007. This is Robert Rodriguez and the Grindhouse. This is part with Quentin Tarantino's Death Proof as well. Planet Terror was awesome though. Death Proof was kind of meh. Planet Terror is gory, it's funny, it's quirky, it's got the Robert Rodriguez style to it. Like From Dusk Till Dawn and all those types of movies. Yeah, Robert Rodriguez is a good, really cool filmmaker. Like I can name a ton of movies that he did, but Planet Terror is really good. Really good, it's worth a watch if you like that campy grindhouse style, which I do. Let's see, like Rose McGowan, she's got the leg with a shotgun. I just remember seeing that at Blockbuster all the time. So moving on to number 8, Final Destination. Saw this in the cinema, as they call it in the UK, but I saw it in theaters. You know, the Cineplex Odeon back in 2000, actually, in Barrie, Ontario. It's kind of crazy. I remember seeing it, too. I remember seeing the plane blow up. I was like, wow. Then all the creative kills that came afterwards. And like the rest of the series is pretty good. It was pretty good. I wanted to, because there's a lot of sequels in this decade as well. So I'm just trying to keep it to one. Because I could put like 4 Saws on there, 3 Final Destinations. It's just not fun doing that. It's easy as well. But number 7, Dawn of the Dead, 2004. This is Zack Snyder's Dawn of the Dead. It was good. I actually really enjoyed this movie. It's got Sarah Pauli, it's got Ving Rhames, it's got, trying to think of all the people. A lot of people in this one. I enjoyed it though. Even the first one was great too. The George A. Romero, Dawn of the Dead, was most excellent. I believe Omar Epps is also in Dawn of the Dead, the 2004. I think it's, or Mekhi Phifer. I get those two mixed up all the time. Hope that isn't racist. I'm sorry. But yeah, moving on to number 6. This one here fucked me up. Martyrs, Canadian movie, 2008. There's a like 15 minute scene in this movie where they're beating the crap out of a girl. But the end of it like almost pays off. It's like, wow, that was kind of an intriguing ending. Watch Martyrs, seriously, if you like a good horror flick, but just remember, you have to have a strong stomach for this movie. It's on, like, top 10, like most hardcore movie to watch. Serbian movie is always, like, at the top, number one, but I think, like, Martyrs is, like, number 6, and funny enough, it's my number 6. It's a hardcore movie to watch. But, like I was saying, the end of it, it's like, wow, I smoked a session with a buddy and watched it. Like 2-3 years ago, because I hadn't seen it, and that I try to stay away from all those hardcore movies that I knew were gonna freak me out, because I don't like the hardcore, I don't like the weird and the macabre, and like I can do horror movies, but I don't like doing it going too far with the horror. Like, a Serbian film I'm never gonna watch ever. Ever. But yeah, I'm gonna move on to number 5. This one is Drag Me to Hell. This is the unofficial 4th movie in the Evil Dead series. I say, some people might disagree with me, but if you watch Drag Me to Hell in 2009, by the way, you get such an Evil Dead feeling. You get like, it feels like Deadites. It feels like the Necronomicon Ex Mortis. You feel that touch that Sam Raimi brought to his Evil Dead series. That he also brought to Drag Me to Hell. The ending of it is great too. I'm not going to spoil it, but the end of it is awesome. Phenomenal. Phenomenal movie, actually. I recommend it highly. It's another one I watched at Blockbuster. All these ones, because this is the decade I worked at Blockbuster, from 2000 to 2010. 2001 to 2011, actually. To be fair. To be fair. So moving on to number 4. This is The Exorcism of Emily Rose. This movie is excellent. Not only does it have a good performance from Deborah from Dexter, Jennifer Carpenter, it's got a really cool plot to it. Laura Linney's in it, Tom Wilkinson. It's very cool because Emily Rose, I'm going to spoil a little bit, she dies. And during the exorcism, and they actually bring the priest to trial, which is cool. So they're trying to prove, did the priest take her off her meds and that's why she died, or did she actually die from being possessed? Intriguing plot. And there's a little bit of like 3:33, which is a trippy time, 3 a.m. like that witching hour between 3 and 4 o'clock in the morning. There's a little bit of that in it. It's just good. I really, really enjoyed it. It's creepy. Like I said, Jennifer Carpenter did really good in it. She got a knack for horror, that one there. She's also in the remake of Wreck. I'm going to have to put that right here. The remake of Wreck. It's not Wreck in the States. It's something else. Wreck was weird, too, because it wasn't zombies. It was like Deadites, like possessed, and the other one, what is it called? I'll look that one up. I'm gonna move on though to number 3. This here is 28 Days Later from 2002. This Danny Boyle, this is Cillian Murphy, this is one of the better zombie movies, because they aren't technically zombies, they're infected because they're still alive, and a zombie technically is somebody who died and came back. So, but 28 Days Later redefined it though. Like, yeah, there's that scene in the tunnel where they're running towards them, and like that's how it really created that running zombie aesthetic. That is scary, but you can't really have running zombies. That's why 28 Days Later is cool, because a zombie is dead. You can't have them running and being all jacked. 28 Days Later is infected, so they're not dead. They're not dead, they're just infected with the rage. So they're like popping with adrenaline at all times, and they're like, you know, the rage virus. It's really well directed. It's really just kind of a scary movie too. There's also that crazy scene. Like, it's awesome watching the making of 28 Days Later, because they actually shut down on like London, like part by part, like district by district, pretty much, to get like those crazy shots of Cillian Murphy walking through London with it dead, like nobody there. And London is like a metropolis, it's huge. So it's just impressive that Danny Boyle accomplished that. So moving on to number 2, this is Saw from 2004. I was surprised it was 2004. I was looking up the date, my movie release dates. I thought it was earlier than that, because they came out with so many Saws between like 2004 and 2009. They came out with like a lot of Saw movies have come out. So from 2004 to now, we're probably looking at over 10, easily over 10 Saw movies, including Jigsaw and Spiral from the Book of Saw. Saw is great though. It's got a good twist ending to it. Really excellent twist ending. The game over. Tobin Bell is great in this series. He's very, very in a very little in the first one, but as it progresses, Tobin Bell has got quite the he's the face of the Saw franchise. It's also directed by James Wan. It became quite the director. James Wan and his buddy. James Wan did all the Insidious, Conjuring. He did one of the Fast and the Furious. He did Aquaman. James Wan's a pretty good director. Now we're moving on to number one. A favorite horror movie of the 2000s. The Devil's Rejects. 2005. Rob Zombie. The sequel to House of a Thousand Corpses. House of a Thousand Corpses was kind of meh. Wasn't very good. Honestly, I thought it was too derivative of Texas Chainsaw. People do like it better, but I just felt, oh my god, this is too much like Texas Chainsaw. Devil's Rejects goes its own way, completely. It goes its own way and becomes its own movie, and I loved it for that. The ending is fantastic. His wife did a great job. Rob Zombie cast his wife in all his movies. Sherry Moon Zombie, I think it is. She's awesome. She's in the Halloween movies too. She's in Lords of Salem. I liked Lords of Salem. A lot of people didn't like it, but I thought it was very atmospheric. I liked it. I didn't even put it in both these top tens, but I just found it very Kubrick-esque, very atmospheric. But yeah, Devil's Rejects, excellent. I could almost do a top 10 Rob Zombie, or rankings of Rob Zombie. I don't think he's done quite 10 movies, but I might rank Rob Zombie's movies. Just because we are coming into the spooky season, I'm gonna be doing probably up to about 1970, maybe 1960, just because I can't really call myself a film guy. It's funny because I don't like anything prior to the 60s. I do, but I don't. I literally just watched Dracula last year on Halloween, and I liked it, but meh. You know, I'm a weird film guy. But yeah, that's my top 10 horror movies from 2000 to 2010. I hope you guys liked it, and if you do, give me a like and subscribe, and ring my bell. Alright, well, have a good one, guys. Peace.